Good afternoon, everybody. Colin here with TechOut. Today we're going to be doing a 24-hour review of the OnePlus 6T on T-Mobile. I picked this device up on Thursday when it came out. Today is Saturday, so I've been using it. I used it for a full day on Friday, a little bit on Thursday, and today is almost the end of day Saturday, and we are still using the device. It is performing wonderfully. As you saw in my last video, there are a few differences between the OnePlus from T-Mobile and the OnePlus you order from OnePlus.net directly from them. This one is not officially unlocked out of the box. It is a T-Mobile device. As you can see on the box there, we do have the T-Mobile branding. So with that, you do get the T-Mobile boot screen. You do get some bloatware. I say bloatware like that because it's not really bloatware on this device. The only apps you get are Name ID, T-Mobile, and Visual Voicemail. Visual Voicemail and Name ID are optional. Those can be fully deleted, not just disabled, but you can actually delete the apps. The T-Mobile app, you cannot delete, but I use that app anyway when I pay my bill, so I download it on all my devices. So really, this phone doesn't have any bloatware to me. There's no pre-installed Facebook app or pre-installed games or any of that junk that's taking up a bunch of space and slowing down your phone or killing your battery. All these apps are apps that you probably already use if you have T-Mobile service. So that really doesn't bother me at all. The other thing is this phone is carrier locked. If you pay off your device or if you buy this in full from T-Mobile, you get, after 40 days, you can have it unlocked. Now they did, I was able to contact T-Mobile on Twitter and they did send an unlock to my IMEI. So I was able to unlock this before the 40-day period was up. I bought mine paid in full. I paid the $579 up front. I didn't finance it. I didn't do a trade-in. So there was nothing owed on my phone still. There were no bill credits or anything like that. So that may depend on if you're doing a trade-in and you're getting bill credits for it, or if you finance the phone, you cannot unlock it until it's fully paid off. So depending on who you talk to at T-Mobile will depend on whether you have to wait that 40 days or not. I find that if you tell them you are using it to do an OEM unlock, which your phone has to be SIM unlocked to get your bootloader unlocked, I found if you tell them you're doing that, they will usually unlock your phone without any problems. You may have to go through a few different people at T-Mobile to get that done, but I didn't have any issues doing that. Second thing is your software updates come directly from T-Mobile on the T-Mobile version, so they are a little bit further behind from OnePlus. But other than that, I mean, it's a regular OnePlus. T-Mobile is selling the 128 gigabyte version with the 8 gigs of RAM. As you can see, it is the mirror black. It's been performing wonderfully, very fast. The in-screen fingerprint sensor worked great. The only time I find that I have issues with it is if my fingers are wet, which I've had issues with regular fingerprint sensors like that anyway. And if my phone is in my pocket and I get like some lint on it, like I was wearing a new pair of pants today, so they had a little bit of like dust or pocket lint in there that got on the screen. And I found that I would have to wipe that off before it would unlock. I had some issues where it would just keep trying to unlock and it wouldn't really recognize my finger. But once I wiped the screen off, that worked fine. And as you can see here, it is very reliable. It does not take too long. So it does work pretty quick. If you have clean hands, your hands are pretty clean, you usually don't have any issues with having it unlock. As you can see here, if you let off too quick, sometimes you do have to try again, but that does take some getting used to. The screen has to be on for you to do it, so if I tap like that, I do have to release my finger and tap the screen to wake it up for the fingerprint sensor to come on. So it's not like one of the ones you can just touch and it wakes up the screen and unlocks the phone. But the cool thing about this one is it does have a raise to wake, so you can raise the phone up and it will turn on the screen and the fingerprint sensor. It does have pocket mode as well, so if you have your hand, if you have your phone in your pocket, you can see it disappears here. So if something is covering the top of the phone, it will turn it off. So if we do that, we can turn it on. It works on the lock screen. A lot of people have been asking me, does it work in apps? Yes, it does. The only app I have I can show you that in is my banking app, so I'm not going to open that up and show you because it has my banking details and all that kind of stuff in there. But it will work. You still get the little fingerprint icon right there, and you touch it, and it works just fine. But like I said, the phone's been performing wonderfully. This is running OnePlus 9.0, OxygenOS 9.0 based on Android Pie. The latest out right now on the unlocked devices is 9.0.4, which does enable some other features that the T-Mobile versions have not gotten yet, such as if you long press on the fingerprint sensor after you unlock it, if like I kept my finger here, I would get apps that would pop up that I can swipe to and open right from there, so you can keep your finger in the same spot and quickly open apps after you unlock your device. That is one of the new features that is rolling out, but like I said, is not available yet because the T-Mobile variants have not gotten the new software update. Everything else is about the same though. Very small notch up here. But with that smaller notch, they did kill off the notification LED. So if you're a big fan of that, you may want to stick to the OnePlus 6. But to me, with the lift to wake or the tap to wake screen right here, you can see your notification icons pretty easily. So the notification LED isn't a big deal for me. I would usually have to look at my phone anyway to see the notification LED, so I can just tap it and check and see what the notification actually is and not worry about remembering what color is what app and all that kind of stuff. So very, very nice phone here. Definitely enjoying it. I think I'm going to go ahead and use this as my daily driver for a little while and keep my iPhone XS Max on the back burner for a bit and get you guys some videos on the OnePlus 6. So I will do another video once that new software comes out for it, but I'm loving it so far. I don't miss the headphone jack. I never really use the headphone jack on my phones anyway, so it's not a big deal. But really loving the OnePlus 6T here. If you guys have any questions, feel free to drop them down in the comments section below, and I will answer them as quickly as I can. This has been Colin with Tech Out. As always, don't forget to comment, rate, and subscribe, and have a great day.